Hello, and welcome to this introductory tutorial on Slide 3. Today, we'll be going over the basics of how to create 3D geometry using the Borehole Manager. With this simple, multifaceted tool, you can use the input parameters from the borehole data to create 3D geometry. The data includes a location, a soil profile with multiple layers, a water table, and the orientation of the borehole. For this specific tutorial, we'll show you how to create a 3D multi-layered soil model with a water table, and then analyze the factor of safety. So, if you're ready to get started, open up the Slide3 program and follow along. We'll begin by opening up one of the tutorial files included with the Slide3 program. To do this, go to the File menu and select Recent Folder, then Tutorials. We'll be using the borehole initial file. This initial file already includes the geometry of the model. What we're going to do is check out a few things in the project settings and then the slip surface options. To open your project settings, click on the project settings icon in the toolbar or go to the analysis menu and select project settings. Begin by going to the units tab and make sure that it's set to metric and the stress is set as KPA. Under the Methods tab, make sure only Spencer is selected as your analysis method. Under the Groundwater tab, leave the default groundwater method set as Water Surfaces with a unit weight of 9.81. Then click OK to close the dialog. We'll now check the Slip Surface option settings. You can do this by going to the Surfaces menu and selecting Slip Surface Options. Click on the Filter Settings button and make sure the minimum depth with 20 meters is selected. Now, click Apply and then click OK to close the dialog. At this point, we can now start entering our borehole data for the model. To do this, we need to open up the Borehole Manager. You can do that by clicking on the Borehole Manager icon in the toolbar, or click on the Material menu and select Borehole Manager. Click on the Add button on the left side of the dialog 3 times to get a total of 4 boreholes. For the first borehole, go to the Materials section and click the Insert Row Below button 2x. You will see 2 extra layers on the materials. Click on the drop-down menu in the Materials tab and assign the first layer to Stratum 1, the second layer to Stratum 2, and the bottom layer as Stratum 3A. Next, click on the Borehole Settings button. This is where you can view and edit the interpolation settings for the boreholes. Modifying these settings allows users to create a smoother interpolation of data points between the boreholes. For this tutorial, we'll leave the settings set to their default, with interpolation set to linear/triangulation, and the resolution set to standard. We will now enter the borehole data for the 4 boreholes. For each borehole, we'll enter the coordinates of the location, the water elevation, and the thickness of each layer. For borehole 1, enter a location of x equals 221, y equals 663, and z equals 202. For the water table, select the method as elevation and enter an elevation of 192. Then enter the material layer thicknesses. Enter layer 1 as 20, layer 2 as 30, and layer 3 as 30. For each borehole, you also want to make sure that the Generate Top Surface or Generate Bottom Surface options are not selected. Now, go to the sidebar and select Borehole 2. For this borehole, enter a location of x equals 331, y equals 757, and z equals 227. Enter a water elevation of 217. Then, enter the material layer thicknesses where layer 1 is 30, layer 2 is 25, and layer 3 is 45. Now we'll move on to borehole 3.
For this borehole, enter a location of x equals 379, y equals 650, and z equals 194. Enter a water elevation of 150, and then enter the material layer thicknesses where layer 1 is 10, layer 2 is 15, and layer 3 is 50. Finally, we'll go to borehole 4. For this borehole, enter a location of x equals 297, y equals 573, and z equals 177. Enter a water elevation of 130, and then enter the material layer thicknesses where layer 1 is 0, layer 2 is 5, and layer 3 is 60. Now that all the borehole data is entered, you can click OK to close the dialog. We will now create external volumes of the model with the boreholes we've just entered. To do that, go to the Geometry menu and select 3D Boolean, and then Divide All. Leave the parameters set as default, and click OK. Next, we'll assign the water table to the materials. Go to the Groundwater menu and select Assign Water to Materials. Under the drop-down menu, select Borehole Water Table, and then click Apply to All Materials. Once this is done, click OK to close the dialog. Finally, we'll now compute our model. To do this, just click on the Compute icon in the toolbar. Using the Spencer method, you can now see that the factor of safety is calculated as approximately 1.4. If you select the Add Surface Safety Map option from the toolbar, you'll see a contour plot of the hot to cold, aka critical to less critical, region of the slope.
And that concludes this Slide 3 tutorial. We hope you learned some useful skills to start building your own models in Slide 3. If you'd like to see more videos like this, you can check out our many playlists on the Rocscience YouTube channel. And while you're there, make sure you subscribe and follow us on social media to get the latest updates. All the links can be found in the description down below. Thanks for watching.